Many of us spend hours in our car behind the wheel each week, cursing at bad drivers and/or traffic. And many times, we imagine ourselves ramming the driver in front of us out of rage, but we never do it because it's our car, and it would cause a big accident and cause all sorts of damage. But amusement parks give us a constructive way to unleash that rage on bumper cars. In this video, I will rank my top 10 favorite sets of bumper cars I have personally ridden. And kicking off this list at number 10 is the Dual Danza Savannah at Granby Zoo. Located at a zoo in Canada, these are among the fastest set of bumper cars I've encountered. It doesn't operate with too many vehicles, and has a center divider. But these are among the hardest hitting cars I've ridden outside the loose scooters. Number 9. Bumper Cars at Funtown USA. There are two things that make Funtown's bumper cars special. One, the 5-minute cycle. I can't think of another set of bumper cars with a longer ride time. Two, head-on collisions are allowed. Yes, you heard that right. These cars have average speed and power, but the lack of a center divider and large number of cars lends itself to head-on collisions, which you can't really get on any other set of bumper cars in the United States. Number 8, Space Scooter at Hansa Park. This is the first of a few odd bumper cars on this list. Space Scooter's cars have average speed and power, but what makes this ride stand out is the dance club atmosphere. The ride has a disco ball, lights, and music. And more importantly, the game of laser tag. Around the outside of the arena are 8 or 9 targets, one for each planet. The goal of the ride is to hit the targets with a laser gun on the front of your car. And it's a lot harder than you'd expect, because the only way to line up each target is to essentially T-bone the wall. It's a really neat twist, and if you realize you're going to lose, spend your time obliterating the other drivers who are zeroing in on targets and not paying attention to you. Number 7. Football Scooter at Europa Park. Another odd set of European bumper cars can be found at Europa Park. Everyone knows how big soccer is in Europe, so Europa Park thought it'd be fun to transform a bumper car arena into a soccer field. There are two teams, and the goal is to score a goal. It seems simple enough, but the game is like kindergarten soccer. It turns into a mosh pit of cars that makes Los Angeles traffic look like it's flowing freely. It's quite hard to score a goal because of the chaotic and cramped arena, but it's very rewarding when you do because it requires teamwork. Number 6. Buzz Lightyear's Astro Blaster at the defunct Disney Quest. Probably the oddest set of bumper cars in America, Buzz Lightyear's Astro Blaster was a game of dodgeball. The driver would scoop up balls, while the co-pilot had a turret to launch those balls at opposing vehicles, and a direct hit would cause the other vehicles to spin out. The mechanics were a bit clunky, but it was really neat to see a set of bumper cars crossed with a shooter. Number 5. Bumper Cars at Interstate Amusement Company in Seaside, Oregon. This town in Oregon is home to a rare set of loose scooters. This set has some drawbacks, though. One, the cars are a bit toned down. Two, the arena is very small. Three, there's a center divider. And four, the arena is super slick. Those four factors can make it challenging to get a bone-jarring collision in, but if you can avoid skidding and line someone up as they round the corner, you can get a collision similar to what you can expect in the ones at Knoebels. For me, there's just something special being in a set of loose scooters, and that nostalgia really bumps these cars up my list, even with the drawbacks. Number 4. Radio Balerne at Tivoli Gardens. Usually I skip modern bumper cars, but as I was walking down the midway at Tivoli Gardens, I heard a thunderous collision coming from their bumper cars. I was intrigued. Like a moth to a flame, I got behind the wheel and found a set of bumper cars just a notch below loose scooters in terms of power. Now add in the fact that Tivoli Gardens doesn't care if you dish out head-on collisions, and you've got a ride that packs a serious punch. Number 3. Bumper Cars at Hoffman's Playland. The now defunct set of loose scooters at Hoffman's Playland were almost as good as the cars at Knoebels. These cars were every bit as fast and powerful, however, the lack of attendance at Hoffman's Playland made it hard to have any targets. I had several rides where I was riding alone with my father. But on the rare days when I got a full crowd of people riding as well, these cars were special. Number 2. Scooters at Knoebels. Considered by many to be the best bumper cars in the world, it's not hard to see why. These loose scooters are impeccably maintained by Knoebels, hit ridiculously hard, and fly around the arena. You hear and feel every collision. The one downside with this set is that the arena does have a center divider, but the sheer power of these cars combined with the love the locals have for this attraction makes it a special experience. And coming in at number one is the El Dorado Auto Scooter in Coney Island, New York. At first glance, this place may look like a nightclub. You have an electric atmosphere with strobes, lasers, disco balls, and booming music. Now add in some of the craziest employees you'll find anywhere. They often stand along the side of a vehicle while they're in motion. It's a really bizarre sight to see and not something you expect in America. And then you have another employee in a supercar. Picture a loose scooter in a field of normal cars. This employee driving that supercar takes no prisoners. His goal was to inflict as much pain on others as possible. Girl stuck in a corner? Smash. Little boy going backwards? Head-on collision. The other cars were head and shoulders stronger than your average cars, but the overall atmosphere and employees made the ride special. So those are my thoughts on my favorite bumper cars. Are you a fan of bumper cars? What are your favorites? I would love to hear your comments and thoughts down below. If you enjoyed this countdown, I'd appreciate if you gave this video a like and considered subscribing, because there'll be a lot more amusement park and roller coaster videos here at Canopy Coaster. Thanks for watching.